Back in 2019, Plague Tale was a surprise hit that came out of nowhere and ended up as one of the best games of that year. And now we have its sequel, Plague Tale Requiem, which technically improved upon the first game in every aspect, and pushed Asobo's studio in-house Zona engine to its limit, with great looking foliage, impressive lighting, insane level of detail, an overall gorgeous presentation. But all these improvements are not for free. The game is extremely demanding. That's why today in this video, and as usual, we will break down each graphic settings and figure out the combination to get the best performance and visuals. So without any further ado, let's get going. In terms of settings, we don't really have much to tweak here. We have DLSS, but official support for FSR or XeSS is missing, which is a real bummer for anyone with non-RTX GPU, because a demanding game like this really needs every upscaling technology. But there is a way to add FSR 2.1 for all GPUs, and I'll leave the link down at the description if you want to try it. There is no anti-aliasing setting in the game, but inside DLSS options we have DLAA. And if we take a look at the game's main menu scene, at this spot here, we can see that DLAA resolves small details better than the game's TAA. And similar story and motion. Here we can see the TAA have more shimmering. But DLAA have one problem or bug at the moment. Any place with water shows these bright spots, and the same thing happens with DLSS. And if this doesn't bother you, DLAA remains a great option if you can spare around 4% of your performance. Now moving on to the most demanding setting in the game, draw distance, which controls the geometry quality and visibility of distance objects. Here standing still, it's a little hard to notice the difference between the four options, but during movement, we can see that low have a lot of pop in, as you can see here. And if we push this setting further, we get more stable objects. But that comes with a big performance hit, because going from low to medium, drop FPS by 7%, to high around 14%, and to ultra a big 22%. Here medium is the best option in my opinion. Visually it have a lot less pop in compared to low, and it doesn't cost a lot. Shadow map controls the quality and resolution of shadows in the game, and strangely enough, this setting doesn't cost much, because going from low to medium costs around 2%, high 3.5%, and ultra 7%. And to verify that this is the case, I've checked a lot of other areas in the game, like here, and the result is identical. Here I think medium or high offers the best balance between good performance and visuals. And one of the weirdest settings in the game is volumetric lighting, because no matter what I did or where I look, I can't find what these settings really change. Like here, you can see that there is a performance hit, but both scenes looks identical, and similar story here with volumetrics everywhere. And since these settings doesn't change anything visually but drop performance, putting it on low is the best option, of course. Next we have ambient occlusion. The game relies on a screen space solution in the form of SSAO. Here low looks a little flat, and from medium things start to look better. And the more we push toward high and ultra, the darker it gets. Performance wise, going from low to medium drop FPS by 1%, to high 3%, and to ultra around 4.5%. Here in my opinion, avoid low if you can, and go for either medium or high. Depth of field affects cutscenes more than normal gameplay. If we compare the four options at this cutscene, we can see that all look similar, and performance is almost identical between them. This one is similar to volumetric lighting, so I recommend keeping it on low to stay on the safe side. Contact shadow is a crucial setting in the game because it captures small details like grass and give them shadows where traditional shadow map failed to do so. And doing that gives the game, and especially foliage, a more realistic look and more depth, as you can see here. And it does all this without a big performance impact, because going from off to ultra only costs around 3%. And if we compare options from low to ultra, visually we can see that going from low we get more intense shadows without any performance hit. Here I don't recommend turning this one off. You will just make the game looks worse without any significant performance gains. Any option from low to ultra will be optimal. Light shaft, as the name suggests, control the quality or resolution of volumetric light shafts. Here, if we zoomed in, we can see that low looks flickery compared to ultra, and performance is almost similar even at this scene with a lot of light shafts like this one. Here I recommend low or medium at best to avoid FPS drops and some scenes. Also, during normal gameplay, you won't notice a big difference between low and ultra. Reflections and Plague Tale Requiem represent the biggest visual weakness in the game. SSR doesn't look great even at the highest options, as you can see here. And performance-wise, going from off to low can cost you around 8%, to medium 9%, high is similar to medium, and ultra around 13%. So even if Reflections doesn't look great, the performance hit is really big. That's why I recommend medium or even low here. And last but not least, we have texture quality, which of course adjusts the quality of textures, like here. VRAM wise, I didn't see the game exceed 6.5GB on my GPU, and I've been playing at 1620p, 1440p, and sometimes 1080p. So I think if you have at least 4GB of VRAM at 1080p, you should be fine in my opinion. Now, before comparing optimized settings and ultra preset, I want to talk about ray tracing. Before the game launch date, Nvidia released a video about RT for Plague Tale Requiem. And strangely enough, the video only had RT on with no RT off comparison, as Nvidia usually do. And now we know why, because the game doesn't have any RT option. Yes, the config file have a line for ray traced shadows, and I set it to 1, but I saw no changes in visuals or performance, as you can see here. So most likely, ray tracing will be added in a future update, in the form of ray traced shadows, and hopefully ray traced reflections as well, because SSR in this game doesn't look great. Now these are my optimized settings. Let's compare them against ultra preset. As you can see at the first area, which by the way, one of the most demanding areas in the game, we saw around 30% boost going from ultra to optimized settings. And of course, you can drop shadows or disable SSR for more FPS. In one hand, Plague Tale Requiem is one of the best looking games this year. And this is an impressive achievement considering that Asobo is a AA studio. But on the other hand, the game is extremely demanding, which necessitates tweaking and changing settings. And the most demanding of these settings are draw distance and screen space reflections. And visually, contact shadow plays a huge role, even though it doesn't cost much to use. The other settings can also return some performance, but nothing significant. And the game is in need of a patch to fix the bug in DLSS and DLAA that cause bright flashes near water. And we arrive at the end. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, or leave a dislike if you didn't. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for any future video. And hopefully I'll see you in the next one, which most likely will be about the PC port of Uncharted.